Hello everyone, I'm going to start with the second lecture on the jet propulsion. So today I'll introduce you with the some important terms which are used in this chapter. First is thrust, and thrust it means it is the force. This is also called the propulsive force. Let us suppose that CA is the vehicle velocity. Vehicle means the aircraft. So let us suppose that this is the aircraft, and this aircraft, it is moving in the air with the velocity CA, and this is also called the approach velocity. Now vehicle, it is moving with this velocity CA, and if we assume that the air is stationary, then air is also entering this aircraft or approaching this aircraft with the velocity CA. So instead, if aircraft is moving with velocity CA, we may also assume that the air is entering this aircraft with velocity CA. So air is entering this aircraft means in the aircraft, this is the turbine. So over here there is a compressor, axial flow compressor, then turbine, and then nozzle. So air enters this compressor with the velocity CA. So assume that the atmospheric air is at rest, thus velocity of air entering the engine relative to the engine is equal to CA. After the combustion, the products of combustion, that is the exhaust gases or the mixture of air and fuel, they come out from this nozzle. So that velocity is CJ. So let CJ is the velocity of jet relative to the nozzle exit. So CJ is velocity of jet with respect to this nozzle exit. So mass of the products leaving the nozzle for 1 kg of air. So everywhere we do the calculations for 1 kg of air. So total amount of mixture will be MA plus MF divided by MA, that is 1 plus MF over MA. So this is the products of combustion for 1 kg of air. It means this is the fuel air ratio. Now force is equal to change in momentum with time. Force is equal to mass into acceleration, m into a, and a is velocity over time. So it means force is equal to m mass velocity divided by time. So mass into velocity divided by time. So mass into velocity, this is the momentum. So force is the change in the momentum with time. Therefore the thrust which is generated by this engine. So thrust, that is the force is generated by the engine. That force, it makes the aircraft move in the front direction, in this direction. Because the aircraft will move in this direction, the shape of the wings of this aircraft, it will be such that for upward force will be generated on the wings, and therefore this aircraft, it will climb the air or it will remain in air. So the function of these turbines and the jet, it is to keep the aircraft moving in this direction, and the function of the wings or the blades which are attached to this aircraft, the function of this is to provide the upward force, and that upward force is only applied if the aircraft, it moves in the forward direction. Therefore the thrust of the jet engine, so this thrust of the jet engine is change in the momentum per unit time. So change in momentum is mass into velocity minus mass into velocity. So here also it is mass, because mass of the air is 1 kg, 1 into CA, and this is mass of air and fuel per kg of air. Now this is divided by time, and that's why it is m dot. This is mass flow rate of fuel. M dot is mass flow rate of air. So already it is divided by time. So 1 plus mf over ma, this CJ, which is the velocity of jet, minus 1 kg of air into CA. CA is the velocity of air which is entering the compressor, or the velocity of the aircraft when the air is stationary. वी मे ऑल्सो निग्लेक्ट बिकॉज द मास ऑफ एयर इज मच मोर एज कम्पेयर टू द मास ऑफ फ्यूल. सो इफ मास ऑफ फ्यूल इज neglected, it means mf m dot f is equal to 0, so it is cj minus ce. So neglecting the mass of fuel, thrust, which is the force generated or the propulsive force, is cj minus ca newtons per kg of air. Second term is thrust power. So it is the rate, it is the time rate of development of useful work achieved by the engine. It is the product of thrust and flight velocity. So this is the thrust. The units of thrust are Newton per kg of air. And if this thrust force is multiplied with the velocity of air, it means Newton per kg of air multiplied by the units of CA is meter per second. So now the units are Newton meter per second per kg of air. So Newton meter is joule and joule per second is watt. So the thrust power is product of thrust multiplied with the speed of the aircraft, and the units are watts per kg of air. In this expression, if mass of the fuel is neglected, it will be zero. Mf dot is zero, so it is cj minus ca multiply ca watt per kg of air. This may be multiplied by 1000 to convert this to kilowatt per kg of air. Third term is propulsive power. So propulsive power, it represents the energy required to change the momentum of mass of flow of gas, and may be expressed as different between the rate of kinetic energy of entering air and exit air. So air is entering at different velocity, and this jet or the products of combustion, they are escaping from the nozzle at a different velocity. So the difference between the kinetic energy associated with these velocities, that is called the propulsive power. So kinetic energy of the products of combustion is half mv square, half 1/2. So this is the mass flow rate of air plus fuel per kg of air, ma plus mf divided by ma into velocity square, that is cj square, minus half mass of air is 1 kg, 1 into velocity of square of velocity, ca square by 2. If mass of the fuel is neglected, mf will be 0, it will be cj square minus ca square divided by 2 kilowatt per kg of air. Next term is propulsive efficiency. So propulsive efficiency is the ratio of thrust power over propulsive power. One point to be noted over here is while defining the thrust power, we have used the term useful air, that is, it is the time rate of development of useful work. Now what is the meaning of this useful work? Thrust power is equal to forward thrust into speed of aircraft. So this is the force which is generated multiplied by the speed of the aircraft. Now the thrust, it is generated by the engine. Now even if the thrust is generated by the engine, there may be a possibility that aircraft is unable to move in the forward direction. Why it will not move in the forward direction? One example is, let us suppose that this aircraft, it is tied to a pole. When it is tied to a pole, the thrust will be generated by this aircraft, but the aircraft will not move in this front direction because it is tied to a pole. In that case, this CA will be zero. So the thrust power which will be developed, it will be zero. Though the force is generated by the engine, but it will not move. It will be of no use. That's why this word, useful word, has been used. Now this term thrust power, it is used because sometimes the aerodynamic profile of the wings or the aircraft, it may not be able to move the air, or the efficiency of moving the aircraft in the air, it may be less because of its faulty design. That's why this term is used. Propulsive power. It is the ratio of thrust power over propulsive power. So thrust power we have already defined, as well as propulsive power we have also derived the expression for this. So divide these two. In case the mass of the fuel it is neglected, it will be Cj minus Ca 2 times Cj minus Ca into Ca over Cj square minus Ca square. So Cj square minus Ca square is equal to Cj plus Ca into Cj minus Ca. So 2 Ca over Cj plus Ca. So it can also be written in this form. Thermal efficiency of plant. Thermal efficiency of the plant, it is the ratio of change in kinetic energy divided by energy input. Energy input is the energy which we get from the fuel, that is mass of fuel multiplied by the calorific value, and for 1 kg of air it is mf over ma into cv. And change in kinetic energy, that is air enters with velocity ca and the jet of air at fuel, it comes out with the velocity cj. So change in kinetic energy is 1 plus mf over ma cj square minus ca square over 2 times into mf over ma ca. So 1000, it has been multiplied with 1000 in the denominator, so we have to have same units in the numerator as well as in the denominator. Overall efficiency of the plant, it is the ratio of useful work done in converting the drag per energy in the per unit energy in the fuel supplied. So overall efficiency is thermal efficiency into the propulsive efficiency. Jet efficiency, it is defined as final kinetic energy of jet divided by isentropic enthalpy drop in the nozzle plus carryover from the turbine. So you all are familiar with the turbojet engine. So once again I am going to explain the working of the turbojet engine. In the turbojet engine there is a diffuser. So air, it enters the diffuser with a very high velocity. So in the diffuser that velocity it is reduced to zero, and then it enters the compressor. Air is compressed over here, then it enters the combustion chamber, then the fuel and air, it is burned in the turbine, and then over here also the air fuel mixture, it expands in the nozzle, so it gives the forward thrust, and the power produced by the turbine is just sufficient to run this compressor. So turbojet may have a centrifugal compressor or axial flow compressor. In the next slide I will show you the turbine engine or the jet engine which has a centrifugal compressor, though mostly axial flow compressors they are used, because with this the specific fuel consumption it reduces by 6 to 8%. With centrifugal compressor the weight is 20% less, because the axial flow compressor, it is heavy in weight. All the power developed by the turbine is absorbed. So this power developed by the turbine, it is absorbed by the compressor and the auxiliaries. So here the auxiliary means in the aircraft sometimes the air conditioning system, that is also used, that includes the auxiliaries, as well as some other power is generated or the electricity is generated, so that includes the auxiliary. After passing through the turbine, the gases further expand in the exhaust nozzle. Gases are ejected into the atmosphere with a greater velocity than the flight velocity, that is Cj is greater than Ca. Engine has a mechanical compressor and can be operated under static conditions. So this is the turbojet engine, in which this is the compressor, this is the combustion chamber, then turbine, and then exhaust, it passes through the nozzle. The compressor pressure ratio is around 6 to 16. Turbine inlet temperature is 1200 Kelvin, एंड इट इज सूटेड फॉर प्रोपेलिंग एयरक्राफ्ट एट ए स्पीड अबव 800 किलोमीटर पर आवर. सो एज द फ्लाइट इंक्रीजेज रैम प्रेशर इंक्रीजेज. सो रैम प्रेशर मीन्स दिस इज अ डिफ्यूज़र. एयर एंटर्स द डिफ्यूज़र विद अ हाई वेलोसिटी. सो व्हेन द वेलोसिटी इज हाई दैट वेलोसिटी इट इज रिड्यूस्ड इन द डिफ्यूज़र एंड द प्रेशर इज इंक्रीज्ड. सो इट इज इन वन वे वी कैन से दैट द एयर विच इज रैम्ड दैट इज ऑल्सो कंप्रेस्ड. सो रैम प्रेशर इंक्रीजेज एज द फ्लाइट स्पीड इट इंक्रीजेज द रैम प्रेशर बिकॉज द वेलोसिटी ऑफ द एयर इंक्रीजेज. देयरफॉर रैम प्रेशर इंक्रीजेज दैट इज बिफोर द एयर इट एंटर्स द कंप्रेसर इट इज ऑलरेडी कंप्रेस्ड. एंड एट ए सुपर सोनिक स्पीड द करेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ द टर्बोजेट इंजन टेंड टू मर्ज विद द रैम जेट. वी विल डिस्कस द रैम जेट आफ्टरवर्ड्स. सो दिस इंजन इट शोज. सो दिस इज ए टर्बाइन एंड इट शोज दैट दिस टर्बाइन इट इज कपल्ड विद द एक्सियल फ्लो कंप्रेसर. सो दीज आर द नंबर ऑफ स्टेजेस ऑफ द एक्सियल फ्लो कंप्रेसर एंड हियर यू कैन सी दैट दीज आर द डिफरेंट कंबशन चैम्बर्स. सो दिस इज द इंजन इन विच इंस्टेड ऑफ एक्सियल फ्लो टर्बाइन द सेंट्रीफ्यूगल कंप्रेसर इट हैज़ बीन यूज्ड. एंड इंस्टेड दीज देर आर टू सेंट्रीफ्यूगल कंप्रेसर्स विच आर यूज्ड. सो एयर एंटर्स फ्रॉम हियर. This is the centrifugal compressor. Air enters from here and then compressed air it comes out from here. Then again air enters the second compressor and compressed air it comes out from this. The advantages of the turbojet engine are the construction it is simple, the mating parts they are less, the weight of the engine is less and the power produced by the engine is more, higher rate of climb, that is if the aircraft it has to increase its altitude then this rate is higher, the vibrations they are less because the rotary machines they are prone to less vibration, fuel can be burned with large range of air fuel ratio. As the speed of the aircraft increases the air it comes at a high velocity, so there is variation in the air fuel ratio, there is variation in the mass of air which enters and therefore the fuel in this it can be burned with a large variation of air fuel ratio. Here much higher speed it can be attained, that is speed as high as 3000 km per hour can be achieved. It has small frontal area, therefore the drag losses they are less. The lubrication system in this it is simple. The disadvantage is it has less efficiency if the speed is less than 600 km per hour. So when the speed is less than 600 km per hour, it means the ramming efficiency or the air which is compressed, the air which is moving at a very high speed in the atmosphere, that ramming efficiency it decreases if the velocity of the aircraft is less. The turbine it produces a lot of noise, so it is noisy. And the turbine it is expensive. At takeoff and climb the thrust is low because at takeoff and at the climb the ramming efficiency it is less, that's why the thrust produced this is low. And that's why this is the reason that in many hilly areas where the length of the runway it is small, at those places the turbojet engine it is not suitable. So instead the turboprop engines they are used. Near to Jalandhar there is a Adampur airport. So that new airport it has been developed last year only. So in that airport the length of the runway it is small, so there is only one flight from New Delhi to Adampur airport. Because the length of the runway it is small, that's why this turbojet engine it is not suitable for that aircraft. And that's why the turboprop engines they are used. The turboprop engines they have higher thrust as compared to this, and therefore the length of the runway for the turboprop engine it is less as compared to the turbojet engines. So one disadvantage of turbojet engine is it requires longer trip as the length of takeoff is too much. So I'm going to show you the video of the turbojet engine. You have already seen this earlier also. This is a compressor moving blade. This is the stationary blade, then moving stationary. So this is a three stage axial flow compressor. Then fuel is burned in the combustion chamber. So front view of the axial flow compressor, it has been shown. This is the second stage of rotation and fixed stage, third stage of the rotating blades, and these blades, they are also fixed. Fuel is burned in the compressed air in the combustion chamber. The number of combustion chambers, they have been shown. This is the front view of the turbine. It is a two-stage turbine. Fixed blade of the turbine, rotating blade. Then fixed blade of the turbine and rotating blade. Then air-fuel mixture, it enters the nozzle. In this figure, the nozzle hasn't been shown properly. Thrust augmentation. One disadvantage of the turbojet engine is it develops less power at the time of takeoff and climb. So that problem it has been solved by afterburning in the tailpipe. So in this, the fuel is burned in afterburner, which is situated between the gas turbine and the nozzle. So before the nozzle, before the air fuel mixture enters the nozzle, additional fuel it is burned, and that additional fuel it is burned only during the takeoff. So when the additional fuel it is burned, 20% additional thrust it is generated, and the rate of additional burning of fuel it is limited by the temperature limit of the burner pipe, because if the temperature is very high, then they may melt also, the nozzle may melt. Disadvantage of afterburning is it is done at the expense of fuel economy and efficiency, because with this the fuel efficiency it decreases. The applications of turbojet engines as well as the thrust augmentation, they are in fighter jets, MiGs and Jaguars. Thank you for that's all for today.